John Bolton trying to distance himself tonight from some of the things he has said in the past as he gears up to replace H.R. McMaster as National Security Advisor. I want to bring in now CNN political commentators Keith Boykin, Peter Beinart, and Ben Ferguson. Hello, one. Hello, all. All here. The gang is all here. A lot of people take issue, Peter, with Bolton's politics. You say that he has some anti-Muslim ties or ties to anti-Muslim groups. What are they?
So John Bolton wrote the foreword to a book co-authored by Pamela Geller called The Post-American Presidency of Barack Obama. And in fact, in the foreword, Bolton says that Barack Obama was a post-American president. Now, if you look at the book itself that he wrote the foreword to, the author, Pamela Geller, says that Barack Obama is trying to impose Sharia law inside the United States. And in fact, Pamela Geller is probably the most notorious anti-Muslim bigot in the United States, a woman who was literally repeatedly called Muslims savages, said Barack Obama was a Muslim, put on the most vile videos in her about women, you know, Muslims having sex with animals. I mean, really horrific, horrific stuff. John Bolton wrote the foreword to her book, a book that claimed that Barack Obama was trying to impose Sharia law.
He wrote that foreword. Pamela Geller's book, again, it's called The Post-American Presidency, Ben, about President Obama. She's known for anti-Muslim, some would say hate speech. Are these the kind of people the president wants to associate with, you think?
I don't think so. I don't think I would have encouraged him to write that forward. I think Pamela says that she plays a role in exposing the truth about Muslim extremism in the world, and some people find that, I think, offensive. I think showing videos that she has showed of actual crimes, horrific crimes being committed by Muslim extremists in the world, those in Al-Qaeda and ISIS, I don't think that there's anything wrong with that.
No, but let's be clear. This is a woman who doesn't just talk about ISIS and Al-Qaeda, a woman who has repeatedly, endlessly defamed Islam itself, saying that it itself is the problem, and suggested that the president of the United States, Barack Obama, was a Muslim trying to impose Sharia law.
Let me play this, Ben. Yeah. This is in 2016. Bolton gave a keynote address to the American Freedom Alliance, which is designated as a hate group by the Southern Poverty Law Center. I want you to listen. This is part of the speech titled, Can Islam and the West Coexist? Watch this.
King Abdullah of Jordan, who is not simply the Muslim king of a Muslim country, unlike our president.
He called Obama a Muslim king. Do you think the president cares, or is that part of the reason that he chose Bolton, is because of that?
Well, you know, remember, Donald Trump spent 5.5 years lying about President Obama's birth certificate and playing around with these sort of anti-Islam, Islamophobic theories as well, catering to this conspiracy theorist crowd in his base. I think that he had to know that these were Bolton's views. He watches Fox News. He saw Bolton on Fox News where he's spewing out this type of this venom. And it's consistent with the other people who Donald Trump has appointed all along. And he doesn't seem to care because there are no consequences for this type of behavior, for these types of appointments. And because this is not an appointment that has to be confirmed by the Senate, there's nothing we can do about it.
That doesn't bother you watching that?
If you've ever seen him, and I've seen him speak multiple times in person, he has a very dry sense of humor. You heard the audience laugh there. I think he was trying to be a little bit humorous and funny. I've watched him at multiple different things speak, whether it be CPAC or others, where he does have a little bit of dry humor. I don't think he actually, when he was saying that, meant it in a serious tone. There's a reason why the audience there, as you heard at the end of that clip, cracked up laughing, because that's John Bolton. He has a guy that makes a little bit of a joke, and he keeps a straight face while he does
it. I didn't see him smiling.
Maybe that's a joke, but you can't explain away all of these different things. He spoke at three times at Pamela Geller's anti-mosque rally in downtown Manhattan. Right? He's a long association with Frank Gaffney, a guy who goes across the country.
Are you referring to the one that was close to the 9/11 grounds?
Yes. Yeah.
Some people would look at that as a little bit different than an anti-rally. It was about being insensitive, and there was a lot of people that agreed with that.
Yeah, I think completely unfounded. He got an award from Frank Gaffney's organization. Frank Gaffney goes around the country testifying against the construction of mosques, saying that Muslims don't deserve First Amendment rights because Islam is a totalitarian political ideology. What bothers me, and I say this as a Jew, is that I know that if someone were saying these things about our people, about Jews, that conservatives like you would be up in arms. So why aren't you when people do it about Muslims?
I've been very clear about this, okay? You're connecting people and then putting words in Bolton's mouth, which he was not a part of.
And he wrote a foreword to the book.
I said earlier, if you listen to what I said, I would not have lent my name to the foreword of that book.
You don't think it's disqualifying?
I think sometimes people in their career, they get asked to do something, they go, sure, I'll write a foreword. Clearly, looking back, I think it was probably not the best decision. Okay? I will say that. I don't have a problem with that. But you're now trying to act as if anybody that he's ever been in the room with or that you disagree with is somehow automatically his policy
policy. You were getting awards from David Duke's organization.
That's not what we're talking about, though.
No, Pamela Geller and Frank Gehry are the equivalent of David Duke.
In your opinion, I would disagree with that. I think Pamela Geller has been very clear.
Well, then you need to learn more about the subject.
Okay, again, you saying that I need to learn more about it doesn't mean that Pamela Geller has not exposed a lot of Muslim extremism in the world, which you then say is somehow bad and the equivalent of something that's absurd. That is not the case here.
Why is it so?
And by the way, the Muslim extremists have also tried to kill her. Why, you do know that.
Why is
absolutely, that's wrong.
And is okay. So let's realize she did show some truth.
Why is it so important to point out Muslim extremists in the world anyway, when we are in the midst of trying to get out of two wars and with Muslim countries in Iraq and Afghanistan? We have horrible relations with Muslim countries. We need to build better relations with this. Having someone like John Bolton in place does nothing for that. In fact, it moves us backwards. Trump has already moved us backwards in relations with Mexico and with other nations, with the quote-unquote shithole countries that he dislikes. Now we're moving backwards again with Islam, and that's not a productive thing for our country as we are fighting a trade war with China, too. How many wars are we going to fight, Ben? How many wars is Trump going to start for?
John Bolton on Fox News tonight after the announcement. Watch this.
During my career, I've written I don't know how many articles and op-eds and opinion pieces I've given. I can't count the number of speeches. I've had countless interviews, maybe a majority of them on Fox in the past 11 years. They're all out there on the public record. I've never been shy about what my views are.
About sharing his views, some of them extreme, like bombing Iran and North Korea, but that's now all behind him?
I think he's saying there's a lot of different things he talked about in different times, and there's different issues going on in the world. Those are policy decisions that clearly have changed now, and they would be different. When he was talking, for example, about dealing with Iran, it was when we had a real issue with their nuclear program and aggression. They were also, let's not forget, Iran was responsible for the majority of the roadside. The majority of the roadside bombs that were killing American soldiers in Iraq at the time, when he did say that we needed to hold them accountable.
3 years ago, and he was opposed to the Iran deal. He wrote the op-ed saying that we should bomb Iran 3 years ago. He was opposed to the Iran deal. He said that the only way to get He said the only way to get Iran to agree to anything is through military action. Guess what? They agreed without military action. He supported the war in Iraq, which everyone, including Trump, has been opposed to now and says he was opposed to at the time. So he's been the key war hawk, warmonger.
I mean, this is Donald Trump got elected saying that, unlike the other Republicans, he thought that the Iraq war was a terrible decision. So now he chooses an architect of the war in Iraq who was involved in changing the evidence that actually brought us into the war in Iraq.
Okay. And he wants to. I would say people in the military would be the ones, the architects of the war.
No, they were taking.